Hello, I'm Bernard Hickey from interest.co.nz and welcome to 90 at 9, brought to you in association with Bank of New Zealand. This is your morning briefing where you get everything you need to know in 90 seconds at 9 o'clock, starting now with news the New Zealand dollar hit a high of 79.7 US cents overnight. It also jumped to 78.3 Australian cents. The Australian dollar is entrenched well over a dollar US now. And the trade weighted index, New Zealand's measure of a basket of currencies, that's also up too. This is all about the impact of a second round of quantitative easing or money printing by the US Federal Reserve. The Dow is up 200 points on this. That's a 2-year high, as all this money that's being printed is pushing people out along the risk curve, if you like, out into riskier assets like stocks and junk bonds and emerging economies. This is causing many to worry about capital controls. This is all about the currency wars that are now well and truly underway. And last night, we got a surprising decision from Canada, which blocked a bid by BHP to buy Potash, a big fertiliser company that's based in Canada. Now, this is all about retaining local control of assets in a world where people are fleeing from the US dollar and trying to buy assets in other currencies. Meanwhile, the European Central Bank held its rates overnight at 1% and said it wasn't planning any response yet to quantitative easing too. The Bank of England also held its own quantitative easing program at £200 billion and held its official interest rate at 0.5%. Also around this issue of quantitative easing, the price of oil rose to a six-month high of $86.5. And Merrill Lynch and JP Morgan are saying it's headed for $100 a barrel. And finally, in Ireland, new cuts announced to its budget overnight of €6 billion. However, its deficit, its budget deficit, is still heading for 11.9% of GDP. Bond yields there rose again, and many financial market players are saying Ireland will have to use the European bailout fund probably sometime next year. I'm Bernard Hickey. That was 90 at 9, brought to you in association with Bank of New Zealand.